Good evening. I am Camille, and it's great to be with you with another exciting and interesting video showcase. Every day in our society, we are faced with the many problems of domestic violence, drug abuse, child abuse, or just to name a few. These are all due to the fact that we have very little respect for each other. And through music, it is said that you can teach children and adults alike almost anything. And with Vincy Carnival 1998 on stream, we are urging our Calypsonians to put their pen to work and create very positive lyrics. Now, he was a finalist in the TNT Calypso Monarch 1998. Here's how one Calypsonian expressed his views on this aspect of our life, which seems lost. Here's Dilamo doing Respect, and we are urging you, the kids, to pay very special attention to this song.
Respect is to have bias for a point of particular reference. Now the reason I took time to give this long definition, this is a quality sadly lacking in our nation. But to find a place in this world, get back from control, this advice is as good as gold. People, open your hearts and pull out your soul. Because as a people, as a nation, as a country, as an individual, as a team, as a family, people, we cannot grow. No, 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 no. If true respect we don't show, so for the laws of the country, little children, to your mommy and daddy, to your principal and also your school teacher, and for all the blessings we get from the master, people, show some respect. Show respect, show respect. Respect must be the objective. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. And I got to get it. Women being abused, raped, murdered, like it's a woman hunting season. What is the root cause? Lack of respect, that's the sole and only reason. Ignorant people say it good for she look for that, maybe because of the clothes she wear. But when a nation losing its soul, you would find few people who really care. So to all the victims, especially the girl at UWE, you have my respect, my love and my sympathy. Terrible scars would remain, your innocence they flush down the drain, and people pretend they don't feel your pain. But sadly, sadly, it gonna happen again. Because as a people, as a nation, as a country, as an individual, as a team, our family, people, we cannot grow. Oh no, 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 no. If true respect we don't show to all women, mothers and sisters as well, show respect, honor the lowest kettle. Don't rob her for pride, rape her in violation. A woman's dignity is her most prized possession. Treat her with respect, show respect, show respect. Respect must be the objective. Hey, 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 hey. About dub music, most people speak in condemnation, and I have to admit, I myself am a true critic, but I have made an important observation. You go
could say the music senseless. You can't understand it. Even say that it's too vulgar. For you will never hear a dub song disrespecting a Jamaican leader. And check any other world music out there, and you would find respect for a leader is clearly defined. But in the land of Trinbago, they ridicule their leaders, yes, so lies, half truths, and innuendo pass off as heavy lyrics in we calypso. Because as a people, as a nation, as a country, as an individual, a team, or a family, we cannot grow. Oh no, 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 no. If true respect we don't show to your East Indian Prime Minister, constructive criticism if you have to offer, but don't disrespect him in your quest to win the monarchy. And then you want to represent you effectively outside the country. People, show the man respect. Show respect, show respect. Respect must be the object. Yeah. Hey, 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 can you hear me? Hey, 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 yeah. Hey, hey, don't misunderstand. Respect is not a one-way street. No, it is not. Honor not only the mighty, respect the poor and the destitute that you meet. Hey. And take this profound message, take it to all the leaders of my land. More respect to the small and humble man. All the promises they make to the people before election, and when they get in power, the freedoms they want to sanction. Broken promise they know they can't keep. Politicians that always talk cheap. The people business in the scrap heap. I better open your eyes, look before you leave. Because as a people, a nation, as a country, as an individual, a team, or a family, people, we cannot grow. Oh no, 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 no. If true respect we don't show, have discipline, be productive and tolerant, our prime minister ought to be the chief servant. The honor and glory he feels that he richly deserves, he can only claim when he truly knows how to serve his people and do it with respect. With respect, with respect. Respect must be the object. Yeah. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Hey. Whether your name, Procro or Cardinal, respect the judges, their decision is final. And anytime we call you the Grand Master, your conduct must always be as an exemplar. Show the people, show the people.
Vincy Carnival Makers Profile. This segment of our program seeks to provide our viewers with information of the persons who make Vincy Mass what it is. From now until the end of Carnival 1998, we will try to bring to you information on the many Carnival makers as we put the spotlight on our Calypsonians, the persons who produce the Carnival band costumes, our musicians, and perhaps you who may have contributed to the development of the festival in some small way.
Ricardo Puzzlegrand is one of the many Vincy Mass makers who very little is known and has been working mainly behind the scenes for a number of years in the mass camp he's been associated with. His introduction to Carnival started as a toddler in 1966 with the late Moby Dick. Puzzles then joined Roy Ralph's mass camp in 1968. And it was while in the care of Roy that Puzzle acquired most of his knowledge and skills as a costume builder. He credits Eric Monk Saunders as the person who inspired him and Roy Ralph as the one who made him excel. Puzzle then became one of the premier mask builders in the Dragons mask camp. And he has fond memories of Patrice Brown's costume, Hark the Herald Angels Sings, when she won the Junior Queen competition. It took Puzzle mere hours to construct the costume. And that has been his hallmark. He strives on the last minute hustles in the mass camp, as he feels that that's the real fun in mass. He has had his fun also as a panis. He first played with the Sean Williams Supertones, then the Apocalypse Steel Orchestra, and the defunct 20th Century. But he left the steel band world because of what he termed the fight down. But he still enjoys the sweet song of steel. Puzzle has been with Blondie Borden Friends since the band's first presentation in 1995. And like the other years he has been associated with mass, he'll be working behind the scene without much attention and fanfare, as that's the way he enjoys his mass. Animal is free.
It's time for a movie line and movie quiz, but first, last week's winners. Our movie quiz winner is Otney Lewis of Upper Edinburgh. That question was taken from The Bodyguard. Our movie line winner is Gabriel Neverson of Prospect. That line was, "They don't call me Die Hard for nothing," and it was taken from the film Yankee Zulu. Now, throughout his acting career, this actor had played many roles. This week's question is, name the film or the actor who disguised himself as a maid working for his ex-wife in order to be close to his children. That is, name the film or the actor who disguised himself as a maid working for his ex-wife in order to be close to his children. The winner will receive 1 week of free rentals, compliments, videos about town. Now, our movie line. Name the star or film of this popular movie line. Movie quiz. This also comes to you at the time compliments of videos about her. But instead of winning 1 week of free rentals, you can win $50. All you have to do is send your entries in care of Video Showcase, PO Box 1375, or to any of their branches. Now, leading up to the Carnival Spirit, we have Focus with Duggie Knows Joseph.
Good evening and welcome to another Focus. On this evening's program, we'll be featuring the Dragons Cultural Organization, which will be launching their mass this Sunday. With me is Miss Rachel Charles, Dragons Public Relations Officer and the defending Queen of the Band. Rachel, good evening.
Hi, Nose. What's up?
Okay. Dragons, everybody been looking forward for this launching. this Sunday?
Right, I've been getting a lot of calls. Everybody wants to know when we are going to launch, what we bring this year. And the band will be launched this Sunday. And the name of the band this year is The Legend of the Feather. And probably a lot of people would be confused by that name, but The Legend of the Feather, it's a story. And what we are trying to depict is to give the people an idea of what feathers are usually used for. So you have sections like Las Vegas, because you know the struggles in Las Vegas, their costumes are always well decorated with a lot of feathers and so forth. So you have that, and then celebration. In celebrations, we use a lot of feathers. Even in the even from tribal days, Africa, and even today, feathers are always used in whatever celebration we have. So those are just two of the sections you'll see. As usual, dragons, colorful. We have a real great master CNOs.
And I think that, some of the mass bands have already launched. I think you may have seen some of the bands that have already come astream. Any comparison along with what you have seen from Dragons?
Well, actually, I don't actually go to the launch in the other bands. Nothing personal, just business. But from what I've seen in the newspaper, as usual, the standard of mass in St. Vincent is high. But you know, Dragons, we don't look at the competition. You know, we just bring what we can bring, and we always bring something fantastic.
Think you'll be in the Band of the Year competition?
Well, we are hoping to once again capture the Band of the Year. We're the band who have won the most Band of the Year ever. So we're looking forward to that, but most of all, we're looking forward to giving our patrons a good mass this year. We're just going to have a good time.
And you, Rachel Charles, defending queen of the band, what we can expect from you?
Well, no, you want me to give her my secret. I have the ingredients, and I think I'm going to do it again this year.
Yeah.
Definitely.
The queen of the band company?
Definitely. No question about it. I spoke to my designer this morning, and we have everything in place. I just want July to come, because I'm ready to take the stage.
And to take this coveted title of queen of the band.
Once again.
Okay. Let's hope that everybody participates in Dragon's presentation this year. I'm Duggie Nose Joseph. Good evening.
We say otherwise. We say clip, clip, clip. We're new and fresh and more gentle. We are meticulous with what we do. That's why we call ourselves professionals. It's Professional Barber Salon, now conveniently at two locations, next to Videos About Town, Honestville and Kingstown. Presently, there is a special on all haircuts. Check this out. Children, $3 plus free arcade game time. Adults, $7. Professional Barber Salon. Boost professional and classy barbers. For appointments, call 456-1276 in Kingstown or 456-574 at Honestville. You'll see the difference with the fabulous haircuts from Professional Barber Salon, located next to Videos About Town, Kingstown, and at Honestville.
Welcome back. Now, school has just reopened and the kids are in their third term, the term in which they prepare for their final exams. Now, this special feature is for persons who would be writing exams soon.
Good day, viewers. I am Miriam Roache and I'm a teacher. I am here to introduce you to the first in a series of programs organized by the Video Showcase and the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Teachers Union. These programs will be featured on the Video Showcase every Wednesday until the end of the term. The aim of this program is to assist students in their preparation for their examination. Now, this is the final term of the school year, and it is the examination term. Students will write their final examinations to be promoted to new classes. Others will be preparing for the common entrance examination, while others will sit the CXC, GCE, and the advanced level examination. Teachers in their final year will also be doing their final examination. We want to take this opportunity to encourage you and to help you to perform well on your tests. Here are some tips. Firstly, you must revise thoroughly. Read your notes carefully. Read them over and over again. Have someone quiz you occasionally. Make time to practice your mathematics and your English language. If you have any difficulties, take some time to ask a teacher or your parents. Secondly, organize your study time. Allocate enough time for each subject area. It will be wise to give extra time to your weaker subjects. Be disciplined. Make a timetable for studying and stick to it. Avoid distractions and disruptions. Get adequate rest. Ensure that you get enough sleep. Please do not push yourself too much. Find time to relax and play. Do not overdo. For those boys and girls writing the common entrance examination, remember this is the most important event of your life at this time. Play a little, study hard. Remember your examination would be on May 22nd of this year. Take care, study hard. Goodbye.
Now, if you have just joined us, you're watching Video Showcase. The Caribbean stars will be celebrating their first anniversary on Saturday, the 25th of April. And as part of that celebration, they're presenting a show called Sparkling Stars and Rainbows at the Cecil Cyrus Squash Complex. Starting time, 7:30 p.m., admission only, $10. Proceeds are in aid of student scholarship fund. And then on Sunday the 26th, Jog and Ready launching their presentation for 1998. They're inviting you to be there. Now up next, Dr. Adrian Fraser with our Black History segment.
This evening we feature King Jaja, with whose name many might be familiar, but are perhaps not sure who he was or how he came to be associated with this country. On June the 9th, 1888, the British ship, the HMS Icarus, sailed into the Kingston Harbor. It was 11 in the morning and the day was a Saturday. On board were King Jaja of Opobo in what is now Nigeria, his son Sunday, and an attendant named Donna. Jaja was the victim of British conspiracy, was tried in Accra, Ghana, on trumped-up charges and sent into exile. The real issue was that he stood between the British and their control of the lucrative palm oil trade. His original destination seemed to have been Grenada, but there was some problem with the accommodation there. Jaja and his party were not allowed to land on that day. Saturday was the customary day when the peasants brought their produce to the market. Governor Walter Hutchinson was not prepared to take any chances. He explained, and I quote, "St. Vincent possesses an unenviable notoriety for disturbances. In 1862, during the administration of Sir Alexander Musgrave, there were serious riots. In 1885, Sir William Robinson was stoned on the wharf, and the house in which he lived in the town was surrounded by a howling mob. And I am informed that there have been several occasions on which people have come into collision with the forces of order." End of quote. That was the governor's explanation for not allowing Jaja to land on the Saturday. But as it turned out, despite the secrecy surrounding the arrangements, a large crowd gathered on the Sunday morning. Also present were members of the council. A carriage was arranged to take the African gentleman to the area of the fort where he had been provided with a house. A loud cheer from a curious Vincentian crowd greeted him. A newspaper of the day, the Sentinel, noted that he wore a Panama straw hat and was attired in a suit resembling an admiral's uniform. A meeting of the Legislative and Executive Council had been convened on the Saturday to draft ordinances for his detention and that of his party, which was later increased with the arrival of his wife Patience and four attendants. An issue of protocol surfaced very early, for the administrator was unsure about the manner in which he was to deal with his guest, the exiled king. He therefore awaited instructions regarding the official attitude to be adopted toward him. Jaja's house at the fort was one formerly occupied by the inspector of police. He found the location too breezy and cool and had to be moved elsewhere, to a house believed to be the one now occupied by the British American Insurance Company and the National Lottery. Jaja never reconciled himself to life in exile. He complained constantly about the lack of an appetite and his inability to digest food. He reminded the authorities that he was an old man, not expected to live much longer. He did not want to spend the remainder of his life in exile, but rather to return to die in the land of his birth. Jaja's presence had aroused the curiosity of Vincentians, no doubt because of the novelty of having an African prince in their midst. He attended numerous social functions where he was introduced to leading members of the society. Generally, however, Jaja was unhappy, reminiscing always about the treachery to which he was exposed and writing regularly to the British authorities in an effort to end his exile. We break this feature on Jaja at this point and will continue with it next week.
Put yourself behind the wheel of a luxury Mitsubishi Diamante car for Carnival. Well, you can own a KFC's great giveaway grand prize. Plus, you win monthly prizes including food processors, electric kettles, CD players, television and radio cassette systems. Also win one of the 100 free KFC meals to be given away every month. All monthly winners will enter the draw for the car. Just purchase any meal at KFC for over $10 and circle the correct answer on the ticket. It's an offer you can't refuse. A chance to win a luxury Mitsubishi Diamante car from KFC, where every day value counts.
To enhance everything you watch and hear in home entertainment, the Music Center takes quality seriously by concentrating on top brands such as Sony, JVC, Aiwa, Panasonic, Toshiba, and a wide range of accessories. Outdoor antennas, boosters, and car audio systems make viewing and listening a pleasure. Buy top brands and electronic appliances at the Music Center. Telephone 456-1746.
Ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said.
Now we're down to the end of this evening's program, but before I leave, here's reminding you of what will be taking place over the weekend. Well, on Saturday the 25th of April, as part of their first anniversary celebration, Caribbean Stars inviting you to their presentation, Sparkling Stars and Rainbows, at the Cecil Cyrus Squash Complex. For further information, you can contact any member of the group or Mrs. Edith Doherty of Beckery. Then on Sunday, Jagan Cultural Organization presents their 1998 presentation, The Legend of the Feather. Now, with all our focus on the youths and education, we leave you with our theme song, Education by the Mighty Sparrow.
Now, if we have any older folks here, sing the chorus. Education, education, this is the foundation of a rising population, needs sound education to be recognized anywhere you go. You gotta have your certificate to show to enjoy any kind of happiness. Knowledge is the key to success. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you go get ready. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You better run dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl. Don't allow idle companions to lead you astray. To earn tomorrow, you got to learn today. Hit it. For employment, yes, employment, you must be intelligent. It's essential, very essential, to have your credential. Remember, if you're blockheaded like a mule, no one will employ a fool. You will be the last one to be hired and the very first one to be fired. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you're gonna catch red hair. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You better off dead, 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 dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl.